Greetings. Waiting for the movie screening?
Just browsing to find which movie would most enhance my nuke experience.
The longer you stick to a path, the harder it gets to abandon it.
Amen to that. Now, tell me, what's the next job for the police's finest duo?
I need information on Spike's whereabouts.
That SOB. I'll never forgive him for what he did to Briggs. Luckily, there ain't much left of the street vultures after the bank heist. They're probably laying low. But now you mention it, I heard about a biker who had a crash near the riverbank just behind the mart. So, your best bet is to check out the scene of the accident, or maybe hit up a nearby mechanic to see if they know anything.
You really want justice for Briggs?
We owe him. But it's more about Daniel and Gale. And I think everyone will sleep better once those butchers are taken care of.
Any witnesses?
There's this crazy old bum who hangs out around there. He's nosy. Maybe he could help.
Are you positive that he escaped on the damaged motorcycle?
Not so much on it as with it. From what I gathered, the bike suffered more than just a dent. I'm guessing he must have dragged it to some nearby mechanic to get it back in shape. I think Ben's shop is the closest.
Thank you. You have given me all I need.
I know you're busy, but there's something that I need your help with.
I will not be involved in any illegal activity.
That's very presumptuous of you. I just need help finding a VHS tape in the rental place across the street. The title slipped my mind, and I assume you've got like a database or something in your head that'll make looking for it a breeze. So what do you say? Will you help me look for it?
If it helps you stay out of trouble, let us proceed.
Yeah, it'll solve all my problems. Let's go!
What are you looking for?
So there's this movie about a guy with a gun, and there's this bad guy who wants something. I'm pretty sure the title has some biblical reference in it.
You lack vital information on the subject.
Okay, let's start searching. Remember, the title has something to do with the Bible, saints, cosmos, or what. Let's start by checking the thriller and drama sections.
Should we ask the owner?
Forget him. He has no idea about movies. He thinks that Salamanca deserved the Golden Piston for the best picture.
I heard that, and it did.
Garden of Earthly Delights.
Oh man, great movie. Very elegant. Panned by the critics, though. But the director is a badass. He personally showed up to one of those ceremonies to accept the award for the worst movie of the year.
We do not need to bow to outside pressure.
Easier said than done, my man.
Diamonds are made under great pressure.
Wait, you think there's a diamond within me? Do you see my shine? I'm just messing with you. That was truly inspirational. But let's get back to it, because that's not our tape.
Kind Shepherd?
Love that one. You know, that movie could have never happened. The director threw out the script after reading a couple of pages. Thankfully, his wife picked it out of the trash, and after reading it, she forced her husband to give it another look.
Everyone deserves a second chance.
Do we? I'm not so sure about that.
There is nothing that you cannot come back from.
Spoken like a true good shepherd. Anyway, I don't want to spoil the mood, but that's not the tape we're looking for.
Nothing in thriller or drama.
Okay, how about you check in the sci-fi and action section? I'll have a look at horror.
Eve's Flower.
Beautiful depiction of violence in that one.
Do you think violence can be beautiful?
It's just shown with a different sensibility to what we're used to. Maybe because the guy's European. You know how they are. It's different. It's cool, is all I'm saying.
Recognizing beauty in something ugly is a unique feature.
Doesn't pay the bills, though. Then again, I don't have bills to pay anyway.
You know movies. There is value in that.
Yep. There's nothing better than a good movie. But we're still missing our tape.
Celestial Decay.
Classic. Still waiting for a sequel. But the guy who did that one has never made a part two in his career. But he said that if he ever did, he'd do a sequel to that one. How do you feel about that? Sequels, remakes, comic book adaptations, etc.
They give hope that there is more.
Yeah. Plus, you get to meet the characters you liked again. That's why I don't hate them. Anyway, risking to sound like a broken record, that's not the tape we're looking for. Hey, I think I found it. I messed up the title a little. It's called Me, Sire. But here it is. Isn't that the tape we're looking for? Tape? What? What tape? You like movies? Do you want to shoot an action movie? I think I'll wait till it comes out on VHS. Lights, camera, action! Crap! I need a hand over here!
Do you need assistance?
It's that metal bird!
First, I hear a bunch of movie puns, and then everyone's...
Where is Pickles?
He ran out the back door.
Where will I find him?
I don't know. But homeless or not, you still have to give an address to get a membership card. Try the computer. Maybe you'll find something there.
Some idiot confused a courthouse with a bank again.
No, I heard one of the accused decided to defend himself.
You're all right.
Talk.
I overheard some Torchhead saying that they were running away from the cops and went through that video store. They had a wad of drug money on them and didn't want the cops taking it, so they hid it in one of the VHS cases. I misheard the title, so I needed help.
That is not the kind of help I was willing to provide.
Come on, give me a break. I fucked up, I know. And I get that you're on a mission to save my life or something. With all that great advice of yours, diamonds are made under great pressure. I'm not a fucking diamond, okay? I'm a junkie. There's just one thing that I need right now.
Which is?
All I need right now is a fix. So, let me keep the money. You won't hear me asking about anything else.
Are you asking a police officer to leave you with money from Nuke Distribution?
I know you're a police officer first, but can't you be a friend this one fucking time?
I am not doing this as a police officer. I am doing it as a friend. Hand over the case.
You can't do this to me, man.
I just did.
Fuck you, Tin Man. I earned that money fair and square.
Greetings, citizen.
The best cop in the hood is back. How can I be of service?
I am here in regards to a fugitive.
Oh, damn. What is wrong with this thing? I need to get that car down, or God knows what might happen. Can you help me out with this? It's new and I don't know where I put the manual.
Stand back.
Go on then. Let's see how it's done. I thought you knew how to bring that car down. Can't be that hard. It doesn't start. Pop the hood. So, do you know what the problem is?
The coil has been disconnected.
That would explain the car not starting.
Spark plugs are not the main culprit. There is no power. Battery is fine, stable, above 12 volts.
That's one thing checked off then.
I detected an electric current inside the cooling tank. I recommend grounding it to fix the problem, but I am sure...
I'm guessing it's an easy fix. It started. We're on the money. Well done, RoboCop. You are one serious Swiss Army man.
I am best at catching criminals. I should get back to it.
You said earlier you were looking for someone.
A biker. Have you repaired any motorcycles recently?
As a matter of fact, I did. This big, chunky guy showed up. Bald head, big ears, and spiky beard. Wasn't really warm and cuddly, but he paid cash in advance. So why would I refuse?
Do you know the whereabouts of this individual?
I don't, but he asked me if I do paint jobs too, then showed me a ripped out page that had a tattoo design on it. He asked me to spray a mean looking bird onto his gas tank.
Why do you think the design was intended for a tattoo?
The page he handed me had other graphics, which were clearly tattoo designs. And, as far as I remember, it had the address of a tattoo parlor that's close by printed on the bottom of the page.
What was the design you sprayed onto his motorcycle?
It was some sort of bird, but I don't know what it's called. I'm not a botanist. But it had a bald head.
Thank you for the information. Proceeding to the tattoo parlor.
Murphy, could you give us a hand? It's gotten real ugly in there.
Did some idiot confuse the courthouse with a bank again?
No. I heard one of the accused decided to defend himself, but I think he took things too literally.
Full metal armor, and you still want piercings. Hey, respect.
I am not here for that.
A tattoo, then. It'll really bring out that jawline.
My body wears enough scars.
Believe me, you can never have enough of these puppies. Anyway, if you're not here for inking, what do you want?
A biker called Spike. I heard he was your customer.
I don't serve no bikers. Don't know who told you that, but it's a load of bull.
Are you denying making tattoos for the street vultures?
You've got no proof, cop. Now stay off my case. I need to get back to my work. What next? You gonna try to tell me that I'm smuggling nuke in a red inker?
Do you?
You still here?
I found evidence of your connections to the biker gang.
I'm not telling you nothing, cop.
Spike and what is left of the street vultures are going down. It is your choice if you want to join them.
Ah, fuck. I told him not to come in here when he was so hot. He brought this on himself.
Where is he?
He's got a place nearby somewhere, but I don't know where exactly.
I am afraid this information is too vague.
His motorcycle must be parked outside. It's some sort of chopper, I don't know. You can check the plate number on that photo.
Wise choice for a scum artist.
Ugh, I can't concentrate with all those reflections bouncing off your armor.
Hey, RoboCop. Mr. Mills would like to have a word. He's waiting in the car.
Still no joy with the broadcast! Fucking OCP's good for nothing piece of shit. Be quiet, moron! Yes! Get working in no time, Mr. Wendell. Sir! Yes! Won't screw it up.
He's using you, just like he used us. He hired us, but he fell to the level. He's willing to do it.
Talk about a sore loser. He had your chance and he blew it. Now it's the toy chance turn. Deal with it, biker bitch. Crush this tin can!
What?
yourself. He needed us to extract brains from corpses. Why brains? You would never say when the juice's cards close to his chest. Where is he? Now? I bet he'd be in front of the screen. Fuck, he's so easy. I'll tell Bond
to me. Operator, requesting an ambulance. One unconscious fugitive suffering heavy blood loss. Operator, Wendell's trail leads to the outskirts west of town. Continue in pursuit. What happened?
Can you believe this? A bunch of repeat offenders came up with a bright idea to storm the courthouse. For some reason, they think that if they destroy it, their prior convictions will go away. They took hostages and are now demanding both the 6,000 SUX and a plane to Acapulco.
Acapulco is a war zone.
I don't think these guys follow the news. But I'm afraid that it may be too late to rescue the hostages if we wait for SWAT.
If they want to fly into a war zone, I have first-class tickets for them.
God! Papa sent you, Robo. God, that was a nightmare!
Robo, if you could call my boss and confirm what happened here. He wouldn't believe that I was taken hostage for the third time this week.
Stay here. The police will come to question you.
Hey, Robo! You showed them!
It was a pleasure to work with you.
First, they can't even connect a few fucking cables, and now they don't even answer.
Shh. It's the new guy. He's waiting for some bigwig to show up. He's planning to do some psycho presentation.
And who is the bigwig?
That's what I want to find out.
Mr. W, we still have no contact with the funhouse.
I'm on the phone. We're ready. I understand, but please tell him that this is not a meeting that can be postponed. I see.
So, they ain't coming, right? Fucking suits!
Keep your anger to yourself, or I'll share mine with you.
Robo?
Who's there? Show yourself!
You'd better not.
As you wish, creep. You are under arrest. Come quietly.
Do you really believe that's what's gonna happen? Take care of him, boys. I'll meet you on the roof.
What's up, metal freak? Forget where you left your car?
You better go, Miss Ortiz. It seems there will be trouble.
It's working! way, you metal fucker! Wanna go for a spin?
We total RoboCap!
Is that you? Come to us.
Yeah, Dad, we're waiting for you.
Are you coming?
It's not your dad, kid. It's not even a police officer. I don't know what it is anymore.
My husband, a police officer killed in the line of duty, were used to create some kind of a metal monster. I need to bury it to move forward with my life. Do you have a funeral suit that would fit that empty shell?
Look at it. It thinks itself as human.
A world-class husband.
A father.
A cop.
Did you hear? It's true. You're not one of us anymore.
You're not human.
And you're not a real cop. You're just the rotting remains of Alex Murphy. You're something that should never have been. Something that should not exist. We have to fix you. We have to erase you. And we will. Just come to us. Come to the rooftop.
We're waiting.
Dad?
doesn't even have a fear. It's the craft that is stuck to our shield. A cuckoo egg planted by OCP. We need to clear our station of this shit. We must smash that thing. Fire at will. You're not one of us. You feel
you
that too, don't
fire?
You?
You're back. There's coffee in the kitchen. Do you like it? The mug.
Dad, can you fix the camera? I think something's broken.
Game this afternoon?
Dad wouldn't miss it, would he?
Pick me up at the station. I'll grab my gear.
Do you really have to go? You look so sexy in that uniform. Why won't you stay a little longer?
Why are you here? Do you not love your family?
No attachments. No leverage. This is a gift.
Don't take him away from me!
Everyone wants to be back home with their families. Be back home.
Welcome, Chopper. Let's take a stroll through your... Oh.
Do you think you can just go back? Go on with your life like nothing happened?
This is a one-family house, built by DM Industries. It's for sale because the head of the family to which it belonged was shot in the head.
Your family has forgotten you. Why do you want to remember them? You attacked something that is the weakest in you, to the part that's still human.
Have you thought it over? Why not make me an offer?
Why carry this burden? What is your sacrifice worth? Holding on to them makes you weak. Destroy them! Destroy them before they destroy you!
Alex Murphy, the one and the only. I'm here because you have something that belongs to me. You have my badge. Lewis gave it to me. Lewis is hurt because of you. Because you keep insisting that you're something that you're not. You think that you are a fusion of me and this metal armor, but you're not me. Not even a part of me. I'm dead and I want to finally rest, but you won't let me. Your delusions keep tormenting me and my family. You need to let us go. I want my badge back. I have it, so I remember. Remember what? The lie? Lewis knows us. She would not lie. Give it to me. It's mine. But, Lewis, I want it back. This is my badge. Then I'll have to take it back myself.
You are strong enough to take him. Don't forget you have a partner who's counting on you. Take this gift. Don't forget who you are. Alex Murphy!
Get up, Robo. Get up, for God's sake. That's it, Robo. Get up. Keep going.
Where's the chopper? The cops will be here any...
Wendell Antonowski?
Haven't you had enough yet?
You are under arrest. You have the right to remain silent.
Relax. I'm not your enemy. If I were, you would have already...
You have the right to an attorney.
I wanted to help you. Release you from the burden of your past life, of your memories. But you don't want to lose them, right? Now I get it.
Anything you say may be used against you.
I can give you back those memories. All of them. We should help each other. We have the same boss! Police!
God damn it, you again?
People need to see this.
Cuff him. He is a cop killer.
Hands behind your back!
Can you hand me my lighter? It's a family heirloom. I wouldn't want to lose it.
You mean this trinket? It'll be safer in the prison depository. You'll pick it up yourself in... I don't know, 150 years?
Plenty of time for rehabilitation.
Top story. Wendell Antonowski, the infamous new guy in town, has been apprehended today. RoboCop was able to capture Antonowski, as reported by an eyewitness, Channel 9 Samantha Ortiz. Unfortunately, no footage of the event has emerged. RoboCop's efforts have prompted a public debate regarding his status as a human being. Here's a statement from John Mills, a candidate for the mayor's office in the upcoming mayoral election.
Today, RoboCop has done more for this city than the current administration has done in its entire term. That's why I feel that it's time to give something back. If elected, I will be advocating to grant RoboCop the status of a free, living human being. That's right. Vote Mills, vote RoboCop.
Staying on the topic of OCP, the CEO of Omni Consumer Products suffered a heart attack earlier today. The self-made entrepreneur has been taken to the Gibson Memorial Hospital for observation. His condition is stable. We wish you a speedy recovery.
Wendell's in prison and the old man is on his way out. Could this day be any better?
Geez, Steph, don't you have any respect?
Here's the man of the hour.
Congrats, Robo! You caught that bastard for what he did to Lewis.
We are not done yet.
Murphy, come talk to me after you're done with your evaluation.
I knew he'd get him. I just knew he'd be the one to bust that asshole.
Glad we have Murphy on the team.
Is that the TV personality I keep seeing on television? Something not many people know about me. I used to be a car mechanic before I landed this job.
Is that supposed to put us at ease, Morgan?
Congratulations on catching Wendell. You seem to constantly be front page news. Not only that, your situation has become a topic of public debate. I imagine that could take a toll on anyone. How are you dealing with other people trying to determine your identity for you?
Someone is fighting for my rights.
That's probably the healthiest way of looking at it. But the status of a human would make you an autonomous being. It opens many doors. Being given human rights would let you fully take control of your life. Is that something that you'd actually want?
Yes, I deserve it.
And why is that?
I am human.
The idea of granting you human rights is a very important issue.
but no more important than the main reason for today's session. Many people might not be aware of that, but I have the whole report on the heavy glitches that you suffered before capturing Wendell. The only other time you've experienced anything similar was during the slaughterhouse incident. That's when your partner was wounded. Now, you were fighting the person responsible for it. Do you think the severity of those glitches is caused by the intense feelings that you have towards either of them?
My partner is important. I needed to do right by her.
I know how close she is to you. Let's dig a little deeper. Your typical glitches are triggered by sensory stimulation, similar to how most people experience memories when exposed to particular sights, sounds, or smells. But this wasn't the case with the other glitches that you experienced recently?
No, they triggered randomly.
That's what I suspected. And now tell me, what did they seem like to you when you experienced them?
Corrupted visions of my past.
I think we're onto something. Your usual glitches were making you recall memories. No more harmful than remembering your wedding day when hearing Mendelssohn's march. We have to differentiate them from those severe malfunctions that you experienced in the slaughterhouse and at the mall. Those latter ones are the real problem, and we need to get to the bottom of it. But I think I've gathered quite a lot of valuable data, and at our next session, I'll present my conclusions.
Hey, Robo, could you stop by the cells on your way to Reed? Someone there wants to speak to you.